Hello guys, it's Dale here with weekly trading ideas video for this week starting today, the 10th of May 2021. Before I go into the trading ideas, let me answer a question which I got pretty often. The question is, which broker do I use and which broker do I recommend? And this is a great question because having a great broker with good regulation, tight spreads, and many instruments to trade is pretty essential for trading. So below this video, there's a link with the broker which I use and which I recommend, so you can check it out, all right? Now let's go into the trading ideas. The first one is on the Euro Japanese Yen. The three charts before you are linked, they all show the Euro Japanese Yen. They always show the same trading instrument. This chart at the top, this is a 60-minute chart with volume profile, which is printed automatically every week. So this is weekly volume profile. Now, this chart with this profile, this is a 30-minute chart, and the profile is fixed profile. You can move it around like that, which is pretty handy. And the last chart is a 15-minute chart where I have 4-hour profiles. Those profiles get printed automatically every 4 hours, and they show how the volumes got distributed throughout those 4 hours. All right, so that's for the layout. Now, the trading idea which I got, well, actually I had two at the beginning. The first one, which was in here, the price reversed and tested it immediately, so it's no longer valid. But the second one, it's based on a trend setup. So basically, when there's an uptrend or a downtrend, what you want to see is how the volumes were distributed throughout that trend. So in this chart, in the 30-minute chart, I just looked into the most recent area of the trend, of the uptrend. I was looking for significant volumes to trade from. There's this significant volume cluster, and there was also this one. Now, a significant volume cluster created within a trend indicates that buyers were adding to their long positions in this area, also in this area, right? So when there's a pullback to those levels should work as supports. So this should work as a support as well as this one. All right, the price should bounce off those supports. Now, the reason it should work as a support is that the buyers who are placing their longs in here and in here should defend their longs. They should defend their long positions. So they don't want the price to go below the place where they placed most of their longs, right? So that's the logic behind this scenario, behind this setup. Now, as I was saying, this significant volume cluster got tested immediately right there. Well, actually, let's have a look at it in here on the 15-minute chart. This is the level. There were the volumes. The price went upwards, tested it, and went upwards again. Also, what I don't really like is that the price tested it that soon, that there was basically a rejection of higher prices, indicating aggressive sellers. So anyways, I had to discard this one, but the lower one is still good, the one at 132.13. So I think that when there's a pullback to 132.13, to that volume cluster, I think that the buyers from this place will want to defend this volume cluster, their volumes, which they placed there, and they'll want to push the price upwards from there again. All right, now let's have a look at this chart, this 60-minute chart. This is the level I was talking about, 132.13. And let's have a look at it from the higher perspective. What caught my eye was this strong rejection of higher prices, and this level worked as a resistance because the price bounced off it, right, in the past. Now, the price went past the level, past that resistance, the buyers pushed the price past that resistance, which turned the resistance into a new support, right? This is a price action setup, which says that when a resistance gets breached, it becomes a support. In here, it clearly worked as a resistance. In here, it became a support. All right, so not only we have the trend setup on the volume profile, but we also have the price action setup, resistance becoming support, and both at the same area in here. All right, they complement each other. So that's the Euro Japanese Yen. And let's now jump into the next trading idea, which is on the Australian dollar Japanese Yen. So this is the Australian dollar Japanese Yen on all the three charts. And also there's an uptrend, very nicely visible. And as I said in the previous trading idea, when there is a trend, you want to look for significant volume clusters. So I used the flexible volume profile over the last trend area, over the most recent trend area, and there are three significant volume clusters. Now, this one, the most recent one, I didn't place a level there yet because there could still be a strong rejection of higher prices and the price could go aggressively downwards. What I want to see is more price action above the level, because this would mean that the market participants consider this a fair value price. They accept the higher prices. That's why I want to see a rotation or some more price action above this zone. But the two levels which are below it are already formed, and the first one is a support at 85.25. The second one is a support at 84.87. Both are based on significant volumes which got created within the uptrend. So I expect that those volumes were mostly buyers who were adding to their long positions and they were pushing the price even higher. So those are strong buyers pushing the price upwards with most of their long positions in those areas. And when there's a pullback, when the price makes it back to those areas, I expect a reaction. I expect those buyers to defend those areas where they placed a lot of their long positions. I expect them to push the price upwards from there again. All right. So that's for the Australian dollar, Japanese yen. And let's now have a look at the last trading pair. And this is also Japanese yen related pair, and it's New Zealand dollar, Japanese yen. So let's start with looking in here on the 60 minute chart and on the weekly volume profile. This is the weekly volume profile. And why I want to look in here first is that the support which I want to show you at 78.82 is at weekly point of control, which is in here. This is where the heaviest volumes throughout the whole previous week got traded. So weekly point of control. Those volumes got accumulated in here in this rotation. This is where the point of control got accumulated. Now from there, buyers took over and pushed the price upwards. So this leads me to believe that in this area, buyers were accumulating their long positions and then they pushed the price upwards. They manipulated the price to go upwards. And when there's a pullback at some point in the future to this area where they placed most of their volumes, most of their trades, those buyers are likely to defend this area, resulting in a new up move. So this is why I think that this 78.82 82 area should work as a support, right? Now, this support is based on a higher time frame and also on a weekly point of control. So I'm going to manage this trade based on the 60 minutes chart, and I'm going to use a wider stop loss and wider take profit than with my standard intraday trades. So ideal place for the stop loss for this trade would be below this rejection before the price went upwards. So before this rejection, that's around 30 pips. And ideal take profit, well, that depends on how the volumes get distributed. What I like to do is base my take profit on volumes, but at least you want to trade this one with risk reward ratio 1, so you don't risk more than what you want to get from the trade. So the take profit should be somewhere, should be at least somewhere in here. All right. Now, if you guys would like to learn more about trading with a volume profile, then visit my website, trader-dale.com, and go in here, trading course and tools. You hit that button, you scroll down a bit. This is what I recommend, the Elite Pack. The Elite Pack is a training program, and it consists of volume profile video course, which is 15-hour long video course on trading with a volume profile. It also consists of my personal trading levels, which you'll be getting every day. Those are daily trading levels, and you will also get my swing trading levels. Now, as a part of the Elite Pack, you are also going to get volume profile pack, which is pack of volume profile indicators, which I developed for ninjatrader 8 and MetTrader 4. And as a bonus, you'll get a VWAP indicator for ninjatrader 8. And what you'll also get is my two books, volume profile, the insider's guide to trading, and order flow book. It's not written in here, but you'll get that as well. It's called order flow trading setups. So you'll get all that in the Elite Pack, and additionally you'll also get free tech support for Elite and Order Flow Pack members. What that means is that our tech support will set up ninjatrader 8 platform for you, they'll install all the indicators, workspaces, they'll set you up with a data feed, and they'll do it completely free of charge. So you won't need to worry about installing all of it, they'll have it in no time. And this will allow you to focus on learning how to trade with volume profile rather than just spending your time setting everything up. All right, so that's the special service which I offer to everybody who gets the Elite Pack. Now, currently we are running a special sale, 50% off of the Elite Pack. It's a Memorial Day sale, and actually we never had a lower price than what we offer right now. So if you're considering getting the Elite Pack, maybe this could be the final push to push you over the edge. All right, so anyways, that's for the currently discounted Elite Pack. I hope you guys like the video. I hope you guys like the trading ideas which I show you every week. Now, before I wrap this video up, I would like to announce the winner of the contest from the previous video. The prize of the contest was a flexible volume profile, which I developed for MetTrader 4 platform. Right now on your screen, you should see the name of the person who won the indicator. So congratulations on winning the profile. And what I'll do is I'll do another contest for the next week, for the next weekly trading ideas video. What you'll need to do to participate in that contest is just leave a comment below the video. And next week I'll randomly pick one person who will win my flexible volume profile indicator for MetTrader 4. All right. So that's for the contest. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I'll be looking forward to seeing you next time. And until then, happy trading.